I'll walk you through steps on how to recover your Facebook account if it was hacked, and the hacker changed all the recovery options such as the phone number, the email, and even the password. So be sure to follow the video to the very end, and if you find it helpful, don't forget to give a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel, turn on the notification bell for more updates. So there are two ways through which you can recover your Facebook account, and the first one is via your Facebook app direct, and the other second one is via the browser. So I'll be walking you through both steps so that you can try out any that can work for you. So for the first one, you're going to open your Facebook app. Then on the login page, instead of entering the mobile number, email or password, you're going to click on forgot password. So when you click on that, you'll be required to find your account by either entering your mobile number or search by email instead. So this time you click search by email instead. So since the email was changed, you're going to enter your full name, so you don't put the email. So after entering the name, then you continue. So from there, you'll be required to enter the code that is sent to the number that your account was registered into. But since you don't have access to it, you click try another way. Then from here, you'll be required to choose the way to log in, either via a code sent to your WhatsApp number or to your email or password. But since you don't have any of them, you click no longer have access to these. But if you don't have this option of no longer have access to this shown on your app, then now you have to open your browser. Then you walk through the steps that I'm going to show you. So on your browser, you go to the search bar and then you type access and downloading Facebook information. So that is what you're going to enter in your browser, and then you search. So in the results generated, you're going to scroll and select the very first link that says accessing and downloading your Facebook information. So you click on that. Then now in the next part, you're going to answer based on the options given. So the first one is what best describes your issue. So you select the second option that says account access troubleshooting. Then in the next one, since the account might not appear on the search results, you're going to select my account has been disabled. Then now in the option at the bottom, they will say please visit the help center. So you click on that link of visit the help center. So from there, you'll be redirected to the help center. But now in the help center, there will be no direct option through which you can recover the account. So you click on the search bar, and while on the search bar, you're going to type hacked Facebook account, and then you enter. So in the results generated, you're going to select the third option that says hacked and fake accounts. So you click on that. So under hacked accounts, you select the first one, that if you think your Facebook account was hacked or someone is using it, then you will see try guided help. Then you click on get started. So from get started, now you'll have to answer these queries. Tell us what's happening. You click on someone else gained access to my account. So from there, the next query will be, sorry to hear that your account has been hacked. Are you able to log into that account? So you click no, I can't log in. So then, do you have access to the email address? So you click no, I don't have access to the phone number or email address on the account. And then you click on that link, facebook.com/login/identify, which will redirect you to the recovery page. So under that, they will ask you to enter your mobile number, but you click search by your email instead. Because the phone number and the emails were changed, then you type your full name and then you can go ahead and search. So your account name will be shown. But if it is not, they will always give you other options through which you can search for your account. So once you have selected your account, then if you had previously logged in, they will ask you to log in via that very link, but you click on try another way. From here now, you will have the options given to you through which you can log in. But since you don't have access to all the above, you click on that option that says no longer have access to this. Then now from here, you can go ahead and enter the new email through which they can reach out to you. So after entering the new email, you make sure that this new email is not used on any other Facebook account. A confirmation code will be sent to that email that you can paste, and then you confirm. So then the next part is to upload your ID. In order to verify your identity. So usually when you're uploading your ID, you ensure that the name on the ID matches with that on the account. If it is not, your ID will be rejected. So these are the options of the type of IDs that you can upload: driver's license, marriage certificate, etc. But for me, since I have the national ID card, I will choose on that. Then you continue. So then you can go ahead and upload a photo of your ID. So you make sure that the photo is very clear, and then you can submit. So after submitting, they will review your ID. Then within about 2 hours or less, you will find another email from Facebook confirming the receipt of your ID, and from there you will have an option to reset your password. So you can click on that link that says reset password, and you'll be able to change your Facebook password, and you'll have access back to your Facebook account. So thanks for watching. You can try these other videos at the end, and don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notification bell for more updates.